Hi, I'm Dr. Nemechek of the Nemechek Protocol. Quick little video blog on diarrhea constipation issues and what's changing when you use either inulin or rifaximin to help with the bacterial overgrowth. Okay. One, the most common intestinal kind of feature you get from bacterial overgrowth, or one of the most common, is loose or more frequent stool. Okay, it doesn't even have to be watery if it's more frequent. Some people like eat and have to go to the bathroom and it's normal formed. We technically call that diarrhea. Or you can be watery stool or occasional watery stool, or certain foods bother you like tomatoes or something and give you watery stool. So bacterial overgrowth, SIBO, tends to cause loose, watery stool, more frequent stool. Autonomic dysfunction, okay, that your autonomic nervous system controls your intestinal tract, and I like to think of it as the intestinal conveyor belt. So you go esophagus and stomach and small intestine and colon, and when the autonomics don't work well, the intestinal conveyor belt slows down. So you can have, like in the stomach, you get some heartburn. Oh, there's Gene brought me some coffee. You get some heartburn, you get the small intestine, you can get a little cramping, and in the colon, you get constipation. Poor conveyor belt action, poor emptying of the colon, all right? Now, what if you got both? Well, you got fast watery stool from SIBO, and you've got slow intestinal function. You got them together. Your stool function can seem kind of normal, okay? It's not too bad, occasional constipation, then you get little looser stool, and kind of fixes things, so it's kind of tolerable. Now, you use rifaximin or inulin, all right? It makes the watery stool part go away, all right? And you're left with the brain stuff that takes the autonomic problem, that takes longer to fix. Now you got constipation. The rifaximin and inulin didn't cause constipation, okay? They made the watery stool portion go away. Now you're seeing the constipation from your autonomic dysfunction, and that tends to get better over time as we fix the brain, all right? So as a general rule, constipation is due to autonomic dysfunction, loose watery stool is due to bacterial overgrowth, and when you have them together, sometimes things can seem kind of normal, or at least not a nuisance. So the inulin and the rifaximin don't cause constipation. They're just showing you the constipation you have underneath from your underlying autonomic dysfunction. I hope you find this helpful. This is Dr. Patrick Nemechek of Nemechek Autonomic Medicine in Buckeye, Arizona. Take care. Bye.